starting our day today up on the Mountain of Olives.
Good morning.
There's George, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed today. So we'll be working our way down the Mount of Olives down to the Garden of Gethsemane. It's a beautiful morning here in Jerusalem. And we are in the area where Jesus gave the teaching on the Our Father. So we have the Our Father in many different languages posted here.
By the entrance, and also it's written Pater Noster. Pater is Father, Noster is our, it's in French, and Eliona it is the Ascension. This is the place of two things happened over here. Queen Helen, the mother of Constantine first, identified the location as the Aliona, and she did build a very longitudinal church, starting from the trees over there, the whole way up till where the bus stops. Okay, it was very nice longitudinal church, and a later period, while they were digging, they discovered this tree over here, and they found a plaque written on it that our Lord, where he taught his disciples the Lord's Prayer. The place over here has been destroyed by the Persians, rebuilt by the Crusaders, and you can see the pointed arches, the Gothic style, okay? 15th century, a duchess from France, she gave money to restore the church after the Muslim destruction of parts of the church. They found the plot. Over here, the tombs have been found, moved, and given a proper burial. And here it has been carpeted in during the Byzantine period. And here our sister standing on the base of the altar. Okay? Till late 60s.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Any other language, guys?
Stood on this stage night after night, reminding the broken. Beautiful view, back of the, down toward the city of Jerusalem. I didn't even see that down there. We got the Dome of the Rock is right there, so we got a beautiful view of that from this side of the Kidron Valley. walking down the Hosanna route, and this is where the people laid their palm branches and cloaks as Jesus had his triumphal entry into the city before he died in his passion. But you can see it's pretty steep. Might be able to ski down this without skis.
Beautiful view of the old part of the city. And kind of dominating there is the Dome of the Rock, which is built on top of the Temple Mount. And then you can see the old city wall.
Jews, Christians, Muslims, whenever we want to bury, we bury in ground. We open a pit, place the body, cover it. Muslims and Jews, they wrap and put the body and put all the debris and stones and everything on top. We bury in wooden caskets. After 1 year, we build this empty monument on top. Why? Because here we believe that bodies, dead bodies, are sacred and you should not walk on them whenever you are in a cemetery. So if you want to walk in a cemetery, you will be bypassing the bodies, the tombs, and not walk on top of them, which is good. Every single faith writes on the tomb, you know, his name, when he was born, when he was diseased, verses from their faith, and so on. $250,000 it cost every single spot here.
Wow.
American Jews, they reserve their spots ahead of time. And why? Because they believe they will be the first to be judged and enter heaven through the Golden Gate. Are you seeing the Golden Gate? See the wall? Go with the wall until you see two arches. You cannot see it there. It's covered with the trees. Come over this side. Honey, cookie, sweetie pie.
We're not charging enough for our cemetery.
Yes.
I think so.
You see the two arches?
I have to.
We wouldn't have no more debt.
Bring that up with the cemetery board.
You see it? No, it's a seal.
That's what is known as the Dormition Abbey. That is the place where Peter denied Jesus outside of the wall. Entering the place known as Dominus Flavit, and this is a place where Jesus wept.
From this time, okay, this is Spina Christi, and you can see the thorns. You see the thorns? You do or not?
Yes.
And by the way, if you bring a branch, it doesn't break; it bends. Yes. As you like, you know, it bends. That's why they could shape a helmet to put it on the head of Jesus.
What kind of tree is this?
Zisipus Spina Christi.
This is the church called Dominus Legit, and this was the view that Jesus would have had over the city of Jerusalem as he wept. Just saying that how Jerusalem did not recognize the time, woe to you, Jerusalem, did not recognize the time of your visitation. How he desired to gather her like a hen with the chicks under her wings. This is looking down at the Jewish cemetery. See all the plots there. And across they built a... The Christians would enter the city of Jerusalem from the east, so the Muslims put a cemetery right there so that they wouldn't be able to use the gate, because they'd enter the gate and then they would go to the tomb of Jesus, which is right over there. Supporting the local economy. This is the Garden of the Agony, and these trees, they date some of them all the way back to 2,500 years. So Jesus may have touched these trees, or as he entered into that agony. And this is a place where the crowd would have come with clubs and swords to take him away, betrayed by a kiss of Judas. View of the church that we were just in, and across the way again you can see the old wall, and that's the Kidron Valley that Jesus would have walked across. We are now going up to the Wailing Wall of the Temple Mount. The dome that is built on this site commemorates the place that Muhammad landed with his flying donkey and on his night journey from Mecca, and then the golden dome over the rock where Abraham was going to sacrifice Isaac, that that's a little bit farther over then. And that's where he would, the Muslims claim that he ascended into heaven in his night journey. So on this corner of the wall here would have been the highest point of the temple, where the temptation, Satan tempted Jesus to throw himself down. The Temple Mount. Okay, so the Temple Mount here, the Wailing Wall, is just part of it's actually the retaining wall of the temple. And so it really wasn't a sacred part of the temple, it was just the retaining wall built by Herod to kind of level things out. So when they pray, they're actually praying towards the Dome of the Rock, because that was built over the rock where Abraham was going to sacrifice Isaac. The Muslims say that it was Ishmael and not Isaac. And so they're praying towards that because that's the closest they can get to it. Well, today was another amazing day here in the Holy Land. And probably not as emotionally intense as a day that we spent like at Calvary or the Holy Sepulchre, things like that. But just being able to, again, to kind of following that theme of being able to walk in the footsteps of Jesus. And today being at the place where Jesus ascended into heaven, or he gave the apostles the Our Father, or going down and to the Garden of Gethsemane and realizing that's been kind of one of the neat things about just being here, is kind of the little things, the rocks or the trees or different things, because a lot of the buildings have been destroyed and rebuilt and different things like that, but the things that may have actually touched Jesus, you know, it's always really kind of neat. And just to see the relationship of like how close things are to one another, and just this is not only this is where he went, but this is why he would have gone there. And so that's been a just really an amazing eye-opening experience. And so I'm just very grateful to be able to have this opportunity.